Tunnels are constructed in a wide range of physical and operational circumstances that determines the type of tunnel used. A number of different techniques are used nowadays to construct the tunnels. Tunnel construction techniques depend on many factors, all of which are project-specific. In order to choose the most appropriate construction technique, aspects such as the ground characteristics, the impact of the tunnel construction on the surroundings, as well as the economic and health and safety issues need to be considered. If the ground is stable, the construction of the tunnel can focus on economics and be driven by the limits of the tunneling equipment. For soft ground, which needs immediate support, construction is driven by the need to support the ground immediately after creation of the void. Cut and cover method is most common soft ground tunneling technique. Welcome to Engineering Concepts. Today we will discuss about cut and cover tunnels. Cut and cover tunnel. This type of tunnel structure is constructed in a braced or anchored, trench type excavation, cut, and this is subsequently backfilled, covered. Pipelines, such as sewers, vehicular tunnels and metro tunnels are often constructed using this technique. There are two methods in construction of cut and cover tunnels. Top-down method. From the ground surface level, the support walls and capping beams are constructed. The walls of tunnel can be constructed using diaphragm walls, contiguous or secant piled walls or another method. The roof of the tunnel structure is then constructed close to the ground surface in a shallow excavation. Access openings are left in this roof structure, but otherwise the ground surface can be reinstated. The remaining construction then takes place beneath this roof structure via the access openings. As some of the surface reinstatement can happen relatively early on in the construction process, the potential disruption in urban areas can be minimized. However, the working conditions are more restricted. Bottom-up method. An excavation is made from the ground surface and the sides are supported. The tunnel is then constructed within this excavation. The tunnel may be of in-situ concrete, precast arches, and corrugated steel arches. The excavation is then backfilled, and the surface reinstated. This method has the benefit of allowing good access to the construction area, but means that the surface reinstatement happens last, which in congested urban areas may be unacceptable. Cast in-situ tunnel in a waterway is also a kind of cut-and-cover tunnel. Where permitted to temporarily block a waterway, and if practical, the tunnel may be constructed in two halves or by using a number of traveling caissons. The first half of the tunnel is constructed within a temporary caisson. On completion of the first half, the waterway above the constructed section is then opened and the second half of the tunnel constructed in a procedure similar to the first. Slide protection gallery tunnels. Cut and cover tunnels are used in mountainous road to cross the active landslide areas. The construction method involves excavation and construction of retaining wall on hillside to stabilize the excavated face. Then, multiple piers/columns are constructed on valley side, finally roof is constructed over them. The sliding slopes are reinstated over the roof of tunnel. In this way, sliding material safely passes over the tunnel without interrupting the flow of traffic or threatening the safety of passengers. Thanks for watching and let us know what do you think.